Thank you. You know, I was in a car accident 3 weeks ago, and I almost didn't make it to this event. The driver of the other cars, he's good, and I'm doing great, other than a stiff neck. But it made me rethink my story for today. But before we get into that, let me take you back to 2015. When I was living in California, preparing for a software demo, and my mouse stopped working. And I was in a bit of a panic because it was a big deal. It's always a big deal. And I was relieved that I could get 4-hour delivery. And 2 hours later, a 5-ton truck that probably averages about 10 miles per gallon showed up at my house. I was excited. That's amazing. But no one really won. My shipping was free. No one made money. I lived at the top of a mountain, and the energy to get it there was significant. Had an environmental impact, and the route was about 10 miles. But the interesting part was I could see the fulfillment center from my home. It was about 2 miles as a bird flies. So being an entrepreneur and working in the geospatial, logistics, and mobility industry, I knew that there needed to be a better way to match the package size with the delivery system. Did you know that 90% of all packages under 5 pounds? Making them ideal for drones. And I knew at the time that drones had the capability to load a package and take it from A to B. But I also know how complicated it is to integrate anything into the national airspace and into our communities. So let's fast forward to 3 weeks ago. So I was home. I kept my son home. He had a nasty cough. And after my last meeting, I jumped in the car and headed to the pharmacy to grab some cough medicine. And pulling into the pharmacy didn't go so well. So standing on the side of the road, a bit embarrassed standing there for an hour. And while I was standing there, I was trying to calculate, what would have this cost in life? In this case, how much did it cost for the police department, tow truck driver, the collision shop, the adjuster? It was about $60,000. So this short trip cost us $60,000. And then I started to do some more research. Now, how often does this happen? There's about 16,000 accidents and 3,700 deaths every day. And 52% of these happen within 5 miles of your home. So these are just a couple examples of my own experience where the safe integration of drones may have relieved some issues that I had, but also we see drones as a way, another type of mobility capability that can fuel human progress in so many ways. So as we look at integrating drones into our national airspace and into our communities, we have the ability from a social equity to help the less fortunate in the sense of usually people that have lower income tend to not benefit from newer technologies. And drone technology and our focus on drones for good can flip that script. Here in Detroit, drone delivery can serve up to 55% of the population. It can deliver packages, prescriptions, meals on wheels, food to about 40,000 people that have low access to vehicles or mobility challenges. And providing these services is estimated to save up to $500 million in healthcare benefits just here in Detroit by providing some of these different types of mobility. And then we look at the environment, which is a big deal when I was living in California, and now I live here in Detroit. But I think about the number of cars that we have on the roads today, and the vehicles that we'll have here tomorrow, electric vehicles, soon to be autonomous vehicles, rideshare vehicles. But I'm seeing some of the problems that we had 6 years ago, in the sense that the package size and the delivery system don't necessarily match. And when we analyzed Detroit, in the sense of adding drone delivery as a complementary technology, not a replacement, we could take about 200 million miles off the roads here in Detroit. That's about 13% of all pickup and deliveries. That would save about 100,000 tons of CO2 emissions, which is about 40,000 acres of new forest. And from the economy, it also helps with safer jobs, roof inspections, utility inspections, job retraining, drivers to pilots, manufacturing, maintaining of these systems. And then we think about the businesses in Detroit as well. Adding 400,000 in increased revenue from having a faster delivery system. As we all know, during COVID, delivery and pickup became pretty important. But this is another vehicle other than drivers, and we have a shortage of drivers as well. And then we look at citizens, the time saving, about 500 million in time savings alone. And again, these stats are on Detroit. So as co-founder and CEO of Airspace Link, we made it our vision and our mission to safely integrate drones into the national airspace and into our communities at scale to further human progress, advancing social equity, the environment, and the economy. So you're probably saying, and when is this, in 20 years? No, it's today. We have a public-private partnership with the FAA, select state and local governments in the drone industry to build the low-altitude digital and physical infrastructures to support these types of operations. Today, we're supporting thousands of recreational and commercial flights every week already. We have COVID test kit deliveries happening in New York. We have medical and organ delivery happening in Ohio. We have pipeline inspections happening in North Dakota. We have food delivery to seniors in Ontario, California. And I'm excited to announce that here in Southeast Michigan, we've been approved to start to do package delivery of medical and prescriptions in Southeast Michigan in the coming this spring. So, it's very exciting for us. And let's face it, drones are fun. The first time that you and your family have a drone delivery, it's going to be an exhilarating experience. I think you'll be excited, and you'll remember it. So something to look forward to in your community. And then we get into, it's not just about drone delivery. Drones provide services beyond delivery. Precision agriculture, dangerous jobs, building, construction, utility, bridge inspections. It's not taking away a job, it's just replacing the way that you go out on that bridge. You're flying the drone out there. Public safety, search and rescue, fire departments can leverage this infrastructure and technology, these highways in the sky. So as we think about Build Back Better, we need the FAA, transportation, and mobility groups to start to think about this next dimension and put in low altitude infrastructure instead of putting in another lane, cutting through a neighborhood, forest, and sticking with the status quo of the number of accidents, injuries, deaths, environmental impact. So please, build back better. Thank you.